Hello students, today we are going to discuss pronoun. See some words: they, we, he, you, she, it, I. What are they? Students, you remember, whenever we describe something, whenever we speak about something or someone else, we don't use their name again and again. We use these words: we, you, he is playing, she is dancing, like this. What are these words? These words are pronoun. So let us understand what is pronoun. Pronouns are words that take the place of nouns or other pronouns. See, types of pronoun. There are six types of pronoun: personal pronoun, possessive pronoun, reflexive pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, interrogative pronoun, and relative pronoun. So now, let us understand one by one. First, personal pronoun. Personal pronouns are the words that take place of nouns. I, we, he, me, she, they, it, etc. All these are the pronouns that take the place of noun and make the sentence easy to speak. For example, I gave him the book. She helped me. You should listen to her. Here you can see underlined words: I, him, she, me, you, her. All these are personal pronouns. We don't use the name instead of I, instead of she, instead of you. So all these are pronouns. We use these words in the place of noun. See next. Possessive pronoun. Possessive pronoun shows ownership or possessions of a noun. Words what we use in the possessive pronoun: mine, yours, ours, hers, theirs, like this. We can use these words where we have to show the ownership. Let's understand with the help of example. This dress is mine, that is yours. Those are his belongings, that pen is yours. Now you can say see underlined words: mine, yours, his, again yours. All these are possessive pronoun and they show ownership. First example, you can see the ownership of dress. So like this. Now third is reflexive pronoun. Reflexive pronoun turns back the action to the subject. It reflects on subject. For example, myself, herself, himself, yourself, itself, all these are reflexive pronoun word. Now let us understand with the help of example. She did all the homework herself. They are responsible for the mess themselves. The work done by whom? They are the responsible. So like this, you can recognize reflexive pronoun and use it in your sentence. Next one, interrogative pronoun. This is very easy pronoun. Interrogative pronoun asks always questions. Whom, who, whose, what, how. All are very familiar to us, these words. WH words we use these words to ask question, like where are you going, how are you. All these are general question. We are using this type of sentence in our day-to-day life. So students, you can make many interrogative sentence by using interrogative pronoun. Now see demonstrative pronoun. Demonstrative pronoun is used to point to something specific things. You can see this, that, these, or those. These four are the demonstrative pronoun. This only used to point out to something. See the example. Those flowers are beautiful. This is my house. So those and these here to point out those, to point out flowers. And this is used for point out house. So students, do like that. Last and next, relative pronoun. Relative pronouns relates or joins a group of words, that, which, whom, who. Now student, there was a confusion. You can see the WH family words we use in interrogative pronoun and also in relative pronoun. What is the difference between it? The major difference is that when WH we used to ask question and use in the beginning of the sentence, that is interrogative sentence or interrogative pronoun. But when we use WH family to join to groups of sentence or the words of sentence, they are the relative pronoun. It is used in the beginning of the sentence, but we can use it in the middle of the sentence also. So students, see the example. This is the dog that beat me yesterday. She is the teacher whom I was talking about. This is the man who saved his life. So here you can see two sentences are joined with the who, whom, that. Like that you can use relative pronoun in your day-to-day life. Students, now thank you.